Hi, this is Robin Bremer, the author of the Kingdom Living series, the Kingdom Living Bible studies, the Kingdom Living pocket guides. And today I want to share with you about the kingdom. Surprise! About the kingdom, because God is revealing more and more to his kids, more and more to me, more and more, excuse me, to you about the kingdom. And let me kind of start in the beginning. There's two kingdoms on the earth. And that is the kingdom of darkness and the kingdom of the Son of Love, this kingdom of God. And in the kingdom of darkness, everything is run. That's what we've been raised up in. That's what we've grew up in, is the kingdom of darkness. We've been taught that if you need more money, you work harder, you get a second job, you sell what you got, you pay your bills, you eat less food. And that's the kingdom of darkness. And in order to get ahead in the kingdom of darkness, you step on who you can, you do what you can do, you do favors, you brown nose and all that kind of stuff. Well, or the kingdom of God is totally opposite and totally a different way. And there's rules that you have to follow on the kingdom of God. Now, in the kingdom of God, we're no longer under the Ten Commandments. We are being led by the Holy Spirit. The Ten Commandments were good and holy, but could not make you good and holy. But the Holy Spirit, through what Jesus did, makes you the whole. Because of what Jesus did, you already are good and holy and righteous. You're right with God. There's no way you can get unright with God. You can sin and mess up your life. You can sin and feel distance from God. He didn't pull away from you. It's your conscience and the devil harassing your conscience, giving you guilt, shame, and condemnation. So, the two kingdoms are, you're now in the old covenant, you were led by the Ten Commandments, and when you messed up, you know, you had to do a sacrifice. Well, Jesus was the last and final sacrifice for all of our sins. So we are now in the new covenant. The new covenant is all about the kingdom. The kingdom is what we were originally created for. In the Garden of Eden, we were created to have dominion over all the animals. If you check in Hebrews and in Psalms 8, I believe it is, it talks about what is man, that you're mindful of him, that you made him to have dominion over all your hands, put everything under his feet. And Jesus brought us back to that. After Adam and Eve sinned, they lost their authority and dominion and sold out to the devil. And he is the god of this world system. He is the god, the king of the kingdom of darkness, which is ruling on the earth. Now, you have to get the mindset of getting out of the kingdom of darkness and into the kingdom of God. And it's not an automatic thing, it's a renewal of the mind. In the kingdom of God, there are rules that you have to follow in order to apply the things that Jesus bought. See, as kings are called to give justice. They have to do justice. The word of God says that one of my favorite scriptures, Ephesians 3, is that God is making known to us, and we're to make known to the principalities, powers, mights, and dominions, God's will, according to what he has already accomplished on the cross. So what has he accomplished on the cross? Healing, prosperity, no condemnation, guilt, shame, but we are righteous, we are holy, we are just, we are the bride of Christ, we are the children of God, we are adopted, we are no longer servants. So all the things that, look at Isaiah 54, what Jesus accomplished on the cross and so much more, redeemed us from the curse of the law and the law of sin and death. Okay, so all those things are what we are supposed to enforce on this earth, which Adam did not enforce in the garden. He should have said, Satan, it's illegal for you to talk to me. I don't know about talk to me, but it's illegal for you to have this kingdom dominion. I have authority over you, and I command you to get out of the garden now. He didn't say that, and this is what Christians aren't saying today. They're letting the devil, they're compromising, and they are keeping things that they don't need to keep. Like they're taking, it's okay to take medicine, but you're taking medicine, and you're accepting the diabetes. You're accepting the high blood pressure. You're not taking authority over it. You're not taking authority over things. You're settling for it because it's become acceptable. But our goal is to bring heaven on earth. Jesus taught us to pray, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Your kingdom come. Your kingdom came. It's inside of us. And now we are supposed to take the government, the kingdom of God, the power of God in us, and enforce what Jesus accomplished on the cross in our world and in our life today. That means that anytime sickness, disease, poverty, lack, fear, weakness tries to come into you, you take authority over it. You take the scriptures and you declare the word. Now, these are the kingdom laws and principles. Number one is the kingdom, the law of love. And everybody thinks that the law of love means that you have to love everybody. But what the law of love really means is God loved us, so now we are capable and able to give the love of God to others. And it should be easy to give the love because we have the power in us to change their life, to change their circumstances. We can take the people that are unlovable and we can love them to Jesus, okay? One of the other laws is the law of agreement. If two walk together, they have to agree. You have to agree with God says, not what the circumstances and situation says. It says, if two of you agree on earth, you can have whatever you ask for. Okay? And you need to agree with God so you can walk with God. The other rule is the law of sowing and reaping. If you look at Matthew 4, I believe it is, the kingdom of God is like a sower going to sow seed. Seed is what God gives us. And he made that clear to us when he put trees on the earth. If you look at fruit trees, not only does the fruit tree have in the fruit that is created to create, but inside the fruit is all the seeds, and inside all the seeds in the fruit is all the trees that will produce more fruit with more seeds with more trees in them. So that is sowing and reaping. It's not like you sow one thing, get one thing back. Heaven's kingdom is you sow one seed, one small itty-bitty thing, and it grows and it expands and it multiplies forever, okay? So the law of sowing and reaping, the law of saying and believing in Mark 4. The law of, okay, so we got sowing and reaping, we got the law of agreement, we have the law of believing and saying, we have the law of love, we have the law of the liberty in the spirit, we have the law of the spirit of life in Christ Jesus. Those are our six laws that we have as Christians in the kingdom of God. Now, not everybody's going to operate in the kingdom of God because most Christians think that it's about going to church, being a good person, trying to be good, trying to obey the law, trying to do this, trying to do that. But it's not about trying anything. It's about resting. It's about resting in what Jesus already accomplished on the cross and enforcing what he accomplished in every area of your life. You don't have to earn it. You don't have to work for it. He already did it. All you have to do is speak it and declare it. A king's words, a decree, we are as kings to decree God's words. We say what God says, and it brings about the manifestation. So that's all I'm going to go over today because that's a lot to swallow. And it's really good news, and the gospel is good news. So my name is RobinBremer.net. Now, word from our sponsors, which is me. If you are trying to lose weight or okay, God basically showed me that in order to do the things that he's called me to do, I have to be in excellent health. I have to have the right weight on my body and be in good health. And you know what? We're representatives of the kingdom. We should look good. We should have the best because we are God's kids, and then we can give the best, okay? So if you are overweight and you feel you're not the best that you can be because you're not healthy, Three out of every four Americans are overweight, which costs you 45% more in health costs and in medical bills and health care. And also, if you're overweight, it takes 10 to 12 years off your life. So it's really, really important to lose weight, to get in shape by eating healthy and losing weight. Pray over your food. Don't be in bondage about eating healthy. Okay, so what I do is I take ACE. I sell ACE. ACE is a suppressant, that's the word. It's a diet suppressant and energy, and it builds and it gives you energy. It's all natural. It's got green tea in it. It's got Garcinia Cambogia, which Dr. Oz promotes as one of the fastest ways to lose weight. And this is without exercise and without diet and changing your diet. And you can do those things and excel it even more. I lost 21 pounds and four dress sizes in 6 weeks. It helped kickstart me into becoming the best me that God created me to be, and it can help kickstart you. Not only that, but you saw the statistics I said a while ago about how many people are overweight. Three out of every four are overweight. That means they're unhealthy. They're unhappy. Okay. So you as a minister, you as a ministry person, or you who are in business, can take this business of ACE, and you can help people feel good, look good, and be healthy. And also, at the same time, you can make money and help them make money, because it's all about team building. It's about team building. So ACE will change your life. It will be awesome for your ministry, especially if you're a pastor or a leader. People can see you losing weight, can see you feeling good about yourself, losing the medication for high blood pressure and diabetes because you pulled off the weight. So if you want a free sample of ACE, just go to a special website I set up just for this. It's called freeacesample.com. So just go to freeacesample.com, A-C-E, freeacesample.com, and I will mail you a free sample packet with information, how you can save lots of money by getting on auto ship, and how you can build a business from your home. Not even from your home, it's from wherever you go. It's awesome. In fact, my upline has made $75,000, and the year isn't even over just selling ACE. It has supplemented her missionary trips all over the world and her business, and I do it because I want the finances to get my books into prisons to change prisoners' lives. I want to get my Kingdom Living books, which can change people's lives, into the back countries and into the woods. I want to have the money to be able to pay somebody to effectively translate it, especially into the Middle Eastern languages and into the languages of India and into those backwoods places. I want to have the money to do that. And this is a tool for me to do that. So go to freeacesample.com and get your free ACE. And my website is robinbremer.net. You can also get there and get more information about ACE by pressing the ACE button. And get on my team. I have training tools. Like, I do these videos, I have training tools. And just get excited and be blessed. And I'll talk to you tomorrow. Oops.